Our next speaker is Professor Shigemi Yoneyama from Kakushin University. Professor Shigemi Yoneyama is a professor of corporate strategy and innovation management at Kakushin University in Japan. He is now a member of the editorial board of Asian Research Policy and International Journal of Technology Marketing. Today, he will speak on the university-industry collaboration and its impact on academic performance of university researchers. Please welcome Professor Shigemi Yoneyama.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Kamatamida. I'm talking about today about university-industry collaboration and its impact on academic performance of university researchers. So this is the research result of the university industry collaboration. The first three, it was published in the discussion paper in NISTEP when I was the director of the NISTEP 2 years ago, until 2 years ago. And I use the Japanese data. In that sense, this is the Japanese experience for you. I hope this would give some hint to consider how to manage university industry collaboration to all the participants in Asia. Okay. So time is very limited. There is only 15 minutes. Firstly, I would like to introduce the abstract of my presentation today. So the purpose of the presentation is to explore the effect of university industry collaboration and its impact on academic performance of university researchers, not on the company, but on the university researchers. Okay. And we pay attention to the prior experience of collaboration, past experience of collaboration of university researchers. And we will present three findings to you today. The first is the impact of university industry collaboration or academic performance depends on whether a researcher has such experience in the past. That is the first findings from me. The second one is that for researchers without past experience, the university industry collaboration has a negative impact on their research activities, in particular on the qualitative aspect. Okay, that is the second findings. The third one is, on the other hand, for those who have prior experience of collaboration, the university industry collaboration has a positive impact on the academic performance up to a certain point, but it turned to be negative beyond that point. I mean that there is an inverse U relationship between university-industry collaboration and the performance. That is our findings. Okay. Okay. Then I will explain in more detail from the background of the study. Okay. So that maybe for all of you policy-related peoples, university-industry collaboration is expected to promote science and technology and then enhance innovation capability of the nations. Okay? However, it is not always the case. It is not always obvious that university industry collaboration is actually useful for R&D activities in companies and universities, especially opinions are separated, opinions are split as to whether the university-industry collaboration is useful for research activities of university researchers. Okay, as for the positive impact, there is many studies which mention that university-industry collaboration expand the size of research activities, and the, also you know, cultivates the capacity of university researchers and stuff like that. So that there is such kind of positive impact was reported. But at the same time, there is a negative impact is also mentioned. For example, some people said, some people said that there is a negative impact because university industry collaboration requires a very time-consuming coordination process between university and company staff, like that. Okay, so that as such, there is a very different opinions concerning the impact of university industry collaboration on academic performance. Okay, so that so what is important to be noticed here is that examining the effort of examining the effect of university industry collaboration on university research is very, very important, because the effect of university researchers is supposed to be influence of the sustainability and continuity of university industry collaboration. Okay, so we have to pay more and more attention to the impact of the university industry collaboration on the academic performance. Okay, then so as for the university industry collaboration and its impact on academic performance, there are several studies recently, and the I mentioned the two contrasting opinions before, but how to reconcile the different opinions. So for example, some professors pay attention to the type of collaboration. Okay, for example, there are various kinds of collaboration between university and industry. So taking this type of collaboration into account, we can reconcile the conflicting opinions. But in this study here, we pay more attention to the prior experience of a collaboration. So we lay our theoretical foundation on the strategy and organization studies in the field of business administration. Okay. So for example, these are the researchers which are paid on the prior experience of collaboration. Okay. So although this is not related to the university industry collaboration, but it is they pick up the importance of prior collaboration on the strategic alliance between companies or collaboration between organizations or stuff like that. So the prior experience of collaboration would play an important role in considering the university industry collaboration too. So that's why I pay attention to this kind of factors to consider the effectiveness of university industry collaboration. Okay, and using these existing study, I set up the three hypotheses. This is very basic one. The first one is about the effect of UIC, university industry collaboration, on academic performance. Is different depending on the presence or absence of prior experience of collaboration. Okay, this is hypothesis one. The hypothesis two is about the researchers without prior experience. So in short, in the case of university researchers without any experience of collaboration with company in the past, the participation in university industry collaboration will have a negative impact to the academic performance. This is hypothesis two. And the hypothesis three is about researchers with such experience in the past. So in this hypothesis, the research with such experience will make a positive impact on the academic performance. That is hypothesis three. Okay. So to realize this kind of, to examine this kind of hypothesis, we conducted theoretical, empirical study about that. And the, in this study, we use the data, joint R&D database of Japanese university researchers, which contains about 2,850 researchers in the database. And the data is about the number of joint R&D projects from the 1983 to 2002. It is very old one, but this is a very systematic and almost perfect database about Japanese university, Japanese university researchers concerning to the university industry collaboration. Okay, and another data is the number of publication every year from 1983 to 2011, and another one is the number of paper citation. Okay, so that we can pick up the data about how many times the university researchers are participating in university industry collaboration, and we can pick up the academic performance too. Okay, so using data, we conducted the analysis. And to do the analysis, we separated the samples into two groups. One group is university researchers without prior experience of university industry collaboration. The another group is researchers with past experience. Okay, and so we analyze two groups by each. Okay, so and the method and the structure of research. as for the prior experience, we looked at the 5 years experience from 1993 to 1997. This five years. So the analysis one, first group has no experience in 5 years, in these 5 years. And this group has more than one experience in these five years. Okay, so we use this kind of group. We analyze this kind of group, and I analyze this kind of groups. Okay, and as for the participation in university industry collaboration, we saw the 3 years participation in this term, 1998 to 2000. So this 3 years participation. Okay, and we will. Investigate the impact of this involvement on the academic performance. The academic performance is measured by the increased rate between this term and this term, the increasing rate in terms of the paper presentation, the number of paper presentation papers, number of papers, and the number of paper citations, and the such kind of things. Okay, so. We will show the result of the analysis. Okay. So this is the first. This is the result of the analysis one. That is the research without prior experience. So this is very small character. So you can see, this one is the red one is there is no participation. In university industry collaboration in 3 years means this term there is no participation is here, right? Okay. And the right one is the more than one participation in university industry collaboration. So you can compare which right one, left one, right one. And you can find that the right one would be lower, okay? And the Another graph is here. Sorry. Okay, here. This is the degree. It's the degree of participation of joint R&D. For example, this one is very, heavily involved in the university-industry collaboration. This is just once or something. This is the degree of university-industry collaboration. And the vertical axis is this is the paper, number of paper, number of citation, including self-citation, number of citation excluding self-citation. Okay, so you can see the negative impact between the degree of UIC participation and the performance. Okay, that means this result means that if you participate in the university industry collaboration, the performance will be lower. Okay, this is a very strong result. I was really surprised. Okay, so that is the result of the researchers without prior experience. Okay, then the analysis two. In this analysis, we checked the relationship for the researchers with prior experience. Okay, so the phenomenon is quite different, become different. For example, this one, the light one, light bar would be higher. This means that if you participate in the university industry collaboration, it would be positively affected to the performance of university industry, performance on the academic performance. Okay? And also we can see the relationship between the degree of participation of R&D, joint R&D, and the academic performance, the paper, citation, including self citation, the citation, number of citation, excluding self-citation. So this is very interesting because there is an inverse to you relations. So that means that up to a certain point, the relationship, the university-industry collaboration give a positive impact to the performance. But beyond that point, the impact will be negative, okay? Okay, that is the result of our presentation. And maybe there is almost over, the time is over, but so just briefly summarize the result. The first, the impact of university-industry collaboration or academic performance depends on whether a researcher has such experience in the past, okay? The first hypothesis is supported, I guess. The second one is about researcher without prior experience. In this case, there is negative impact to the of the university industry collaboration on the academic performance of the university researchers. Okay, the third one is about researchers with prior experience of collaboration. In this case, there was an inverse U relationship between university-industry collaboration and academic performance. Okay, that is the findings. And the last one is the policy implication. I will just give the two points. The first, for the researchers who participate in collaboration with companies for the first time, the policy practitioner should prepare some supporting measures, such as because the collaboration could give a negative influence on the academic performance. Okay, such kind of supporting measure is needed for the firstly involved in the university-industry collaboration. Okay, then on the other hand, the researcher who had prior experience, it is important to let them know that excessive engagement of UIC may make an adverse impact of their research activities. So control the effort ratio between the academic studies and the university industry collaboration shall be managed. Okay? That is our point. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Professor Yonezuma.